all the dignitaries on the dais and senior officials from different states, NGOs and manage team. It is my great humble opportunity to participate in this prestigious institute managed for the purpose of mechanization as we know this sector has some different scenario in our country. It is still in nascent stage, and in last 2 decades the growth rate is about 5% in country. For mechanization has some special challenges, like we have large number of small marginal farmers and declining land holdings by family divisions, high cost of machines and equipments, and in India we have very limited infrastructural facility, particularly in rural areas. And lastly, no doubt we have insufficient policy network in our country, very limited resource for promotion of mechanization in the field of extension and other activities, limited funds are available from government side. So we have different type of challenges in the field of mechanization. So in this situation, how we can go ahead to promote mechanization, especially for small and marginal farmers of our country, by which they can increase their productivity, they can take benefits of new technology and machines. When I took charge as director, so I decided, I saw that there is no policy, no streamlined mechanism in the state for promotion of this mechanization. Then I decided to start with some points, and then government intervention, in which government take several steps, and after a period of 8 to 10 years we have achieved tremendous growth in the field of mechanization in Madhya Pradesh. So morning ma'am, I am just telling that this sector has some critical challenges. We have a large number of small marginal farmers, declining land holding size by family politicians, high cost of equipments, and poor infrastructural facility in the country, and lastly insufficient policy network. So these are the main challenges by which the impact of mechanization is still not very visible in the country. In Madhya Pradesh we took several steps. I will tell one by one. And as in other states, we have also 43% marginal farmer, 27% small, so almost 70% farmers belongs to these two categories. So this is the big challenge. When we compare India with other countries, so the population engaged in agriculture sector, as you say, in India about 55% population depends on agriculture, whereas in US 95% mechanization level and only 2.4% are depends on. So we have totally different scenario in our country. Farm power availability, as we know, it has direct relation with the productivity. So as you see in MP, in 2011-12 we have 1.11 kilowatt, and last year we have crossed the national average. Now we have 2.06 kilowatt per hectare, whereas the national average is 1.96. Farm power sharing means in farm power, agriculture worker, animal, tractor, power tiller, diesel engine and electric motors. So it is the assumption that now the main role in farm power is still main player is tractor, and human power is decreasing. In 71-72 it was 15% and now it comes about 3%. As I told, it has direct relation with farm productivity or production. So in MP in 2005-06 when farm power was 0.74 kilowatt, our total production was 2.02 crores metric ton, and in 16-17 our production 5.26 crore metric ton. And as you know, since the last 5 years MP is getting Krishi Karman Award and tremendous jump in total production. These are the main contribution of major factors. A study conducted by World Bank shows that these are the four major components or factors by which MP is getting huge production growth. In 2004-05 the irrigated area was 46.31. Now we have 110 lakh hectare and an increase of 137%. In certified seed, from 14 to 40 lakh hectare, fertilizer consumption is almost increased by 73%. And lastly, farm power has increased from 0.74 to 2.06, an increase of 178%. World Bank has studied this sanctioning a new project in MP on farm mechanization of about 300 crores. It is under pipeline and we think this will start very soon. This sector was previously not defined. So when we start to plan in the year 2010-11, state has decided to make district for mechanization. These plans are prepared with the help of district collectors, district agriculture officers, to identify the situation, the current scenario, the demand of public, and in these plans, five main areas were identified where state has to do something. Number one is technology transfer. We have sufficient technology in our country. ICR is developing latest technology, but these technologies are not available with farmers of our country. So number one is the technology transfer. Number two is the availability of implements. In this sector, major implements are distributed on subsidy programs of different central government schemes or in state government schemes. But the system of these schemes are not very friendly with farmers. Different schemes have different norms of subsidy pattern or a different procedure. So farmers are facing a lot of problem. Next is small marginal farmers have, due to their poor financial condition, they are unable to take advantage of these new machines. And infrastructural facility, especially in the rural area, is not exist. So farmers are not able to get facility of repair and maintenance in this area. And lastly, in the state of Madhya Pradesh, we have some pockets where some special or some different type of problems are there. In some area, we have problem of broadcasting method of sowing in tribal region. So in some part, heavy rain every year causes loss in productivity of soybean. So every state has some special problem. So these are the five major areas. These were identified in our plan. And after getting these points, state government has decided to tackle one by one. For technology transfer, a state scheme was launched, and in this scheme, Yantradut program means a village is adopted by government. Initially, we started this program in just 25 villages, and complete package of mechanization were provided by government through demonstrations and other demonstration, field visits, sangosthis like these. So this program has changed the mentality of farmers. Now farmers are ready to adopt costly implements also. Before this, they were not very much familiar with new machines, but after implementing this program, now a huge demand of new implements from farmers are now coming. These are the benefits, as it is also mentioned by ICR: saving in seed, saving in fertilizer, time saving, saving in labor, cropping intensity, productivity increase, and overall income. We saw the major interventions in Yantradut, deploying the main work that was started in the month of April, May, increases productivity by 50 to 20%, then better seed bed, improved sowing practices. This is also very important, because still in Madhya Pradesh, maximum farmers are using simple seed drills. It means they are using seed and mixing fertilizer with seed, and sowing is taken place. So by improving these practices, especially in kharif crops, we introduce raised bed planting in a huge way, Now, raised bed planters are very popular in Madhya Pradesh, and several manufacturers are now producing this implement. So, it shows a great change in the productivity of soybean or pulses, especially in kharif crops, where heavy rains destroy their crops every year. So this saves 0-till and happy seeder are also two technology, especially in the paddy wheat region. And in one district of Madhya Pradesh, Balaghat, completely paddy district, so where we took a special drive to promote mechanized transplanting, and in 1 year we introduced about 250 rice transplanter in one district, and the productivity was increased from 70 to 100%. These are some other interventions. So lastly, we can say overall increase in the income of these villages has increased 40-50% in some villages, more than 50%. Now, as we got second point, availability of implements, as I told, government has different mechanism in different schemes, and in my state farmers were facing a lot of problem in getting benefits in subsidy programs. They have to reach the agriculture office, district office, block office, and put their different type of documents there, and local officers allowed them to purchase, and there were no guarantee how much time they will take to get the subsidy. So last year we have decided to start a new system of subsidy disbursement, and this is completely transparent online system in which farmer doesn't go to any office of department. He allows to purchase an implement from local market with registered dealer. So initially we register all leading manufacturers, and the registration process is also completely online. A manufacturer from Gujarat or from Chennai, from Hyderabad can register online. We have a system like passport system. After registration, he will get a self-generated mail. On that particular date, he has to submit his document to verify his original certificates at Directorate Bhopal, and got registration online. So this system has now started, and now we have about 298 manufacturers are now working with this online system, and about there more than 11,000 dealers are now registered with the state. So farmers are free to purchase their implement at any one of these 11,000 dealers. From anywhere he can purchase his implement. And one more important thing is that government is not deciding their cost. We are now taking rates from manufacturer These rates are available on portal, and farmers are advised to take implement on these rates, or they can bargain at below price, but not more than this. So now in the state, farmers are now bargaining, so they are free. And we last year yesterday I took figures, and about 15 to 25% rebate are now getting farmers on the on the portal price. So this is the advantage. And in this system, farmers has to apply online. When target is available, he can book from anywhere. After booking, he will get a SMS on his mobile to purchase implement within a period of 20 days. Dealer. In these 20 days, he decided, and different dealers also get same message from portal that particular farmer wants to purchase implement. So all dealers approaches to that particular farmer and give their best and quote their best rates, and farmer ultimately bargain and finalize his machine and cost. After purchasing, because the application is done through thumb impression device, so it is already linked with Aadhaar system, so there is no chance of fraud case. After purchasing, bills and other documents of farmer were uploaded by dealer. Then the application with documents and bills goes to that particular manufacturer, and manufacturer certifies that the bills and these machines with serial number so and so are supplied by us to that particular dealer, and the case is ready for subsidy disbursement. Then the case was transferred to our physical verification officer. He visits the field and took photographs and verify all documents with original ones and submit his report online on that case. After submission of his report, a cell is formed at directorate level, so case is ready for subsidy disbursement, and subsidy is released through RTGS system of treasury within 2 to 3 days. Farmer will get subsidy in his account with SMS. So this is the complete transparent time bound system, and now dealers, manufacturers and farmers are very happy with this type of system, and within yes, I will show later on. And in this portal, we pooled different funds available in different schemes. Now about this year, we planned about 240 crores for this portal. So farmer have good chances to get subsidy timely. And one more important thing is that if a farmer registered in this portal and applies, he will get subsidy 100% guarantee from government. If target is not available in the portal, the application system will close automatically. So before starting this system, in district officers, they provide permissions to farmers, and after completion of funds, farmers were waiting for their subsidy till 6 months or more than 1 year or 2 years. So if funds are available with government, the system, this portal will work, and as when the funds exhausted, the system will automatically close. These are the main features: transparent online system, automatic generation of sanction order, DBT in cash in kind is assured, time bound activity, subsidy releases through RTGS, minimized interaction with departmental officers, Aadhaar linkage is assured, and the system is suitable for DBT Bharat mission. Now we have linked our system with Government of India as they are in their DBT portal. So after releasing subsidy, the beneficiary name with Aadhaar number automatically transferred to GOI without any delay. One more thing that was done in Madhya Pradesh was for high cost new technology machines. We identified 19 machines with the help of CIAE, and state government has decided to provide additional top-up subsidy on these machines in addition to subsidy available in GOI schemes. The second part of the plan, how we can provide technologies to small and marginal farmers. As Sharma sir told us, that this was a very important for this meeting. So in year 2012-13, Pradesh started custom hiring model. In this model, we are providing 40, initially ma'am, we were providing 50% subsidy in Madhya Pradesh, but after starting of SMEM from GOI, so we reduced it to 40%, and 40% subsidy is available, and additional 10% subsidy is available to SCST farmers. So SCST farmers are now getting 50%, and in Madhya Pradesh the model of custom hiring center is totally based on rural youth and in private sector, and from 2012-13 to 2017-18, we have established more than 2000 centers. 2278 custom hiring centers are now working. We have some different criteria in Madhya Pradesh, because we started our program in 12-13, and from 14-15, Government of India has started this program in SMEM. So when SMEM was forming, I was involved in this process. So we have some criteria that we have minimum age of 18 years, and a 12th pass student is necessary. In addition to, we have one more criteria that is not mentioned here, that agriculture graduates wants to establish custom herring, he will get we have about 20% centers are now reserved for agriculture graduates. In this center, applications are invited completely online. Now we are invite for
CM program is going on.
No,
the government of India.
No, ma'am. We have a target of 10 centers in each district. So, in these 10 centers, we have reservation of 2 centers for agriculture graduates.
My suggestion is, under OCABC, manage is giving 2 months training.
Okay.
They are also eligible for subsidy and bank loan. Under ACABC, not only agriculture graduate, diploma in agriculture, polytechnic students, they are also eligible. I am telling, instead of agri graduates, you can reserve for ACABC trained.
So we will amend it.
I think that way, then you will get more trained.
We will allow them also. So, in our model, we have some criteria of compulsory equipment. So we are allowing centers of up to 25 lakhs. So we have 7 compulsory equipments. It means number 1 is tractor, number 2 reversible plow, cultivator, disc harrow, rotavator, seed cum fertilizer drill, raised bed planter or rice transplanter, multi-crop thresher or straw reaper. Straw reaper is especially for area where harvesting is done through combines, so we are promoting straw reaper in that area. So the cost of these equipments is about 12 to 14 lakhs. So when we are allowing 25 lakhs, so far applicant has a choice of additional 10 lakhs. So, in addition to these, he can select implements as per their local need, or he can multiply them. We are providing a list of 34 implements in addition, which, and after making a project, applied in the bank, and when bank gave us primary consent to the loan, then beneficiary will take a 1 week training. It is mandatory in our scheme, and training is provided at CIAE Bhopal or FMTTI Budhni. We have continue batches in the center, and a study conducted by NARM year 2 years ago, that about 4 to 5 youths are getting employment. In addition to these custom hiring centers, we are also promoting high-tech hubs from 40 lakhs to 2 crores, and in Madhya Pradesh about 115 high-tech hubs are now working, including 47 sugarcane harvesters hub with the same norm as in custom hiring model, 40% subsidy. In the scheme of custom hiring, one very much important role of bank is very important. So first we decided to get clear this scheme from SLBC, and from SLBC headed by our chief secretary, and it is cleared by SLBC, then conveyed to all bankers. But ma'am, one issue is still with banks, that is with collateral issue. So this matter has been taken by us with GOI, and I think some intervention from RBI is necessary, because rural people or farmers doesn't have enough property in urban areas, and in banking criteria they mortgage or they take collateral as urban properties, not agriculture land. So it is really very difficult to get sanction of loan from bank. So this is a challenge and very
centers.
Yes, definitely all centers are getting profit, and
the easiest way is, instead of talking to Government of India, RBI and all, since subsidy is back ended only,
yes,
unless the beneficiary pays the loan, they will not be getting subsidy. The easiest solution for this problem is just giving the state government security, because it's a wonderful.
No, we are providing CGTMSC, and state government is taking security. But even these bankers are creating.
But when state gives security, there is no looking back.
All we have a lock-in period of 4 years in bank loan. Beneficiary can't repay his full loan amount within a period of 4 years. So after completion of this lock-in period,
lock-in period in this kind of system should not be more than 3-4 months, because machines, they are going to get continuous income. So why there should be lock-in period of 4 years?
The main criteria was fixing lock-in period was if a farmer get benefit of 40% subsidy and he sells all machine to third person after 1 year. So the main motto of establishing custom hiring will...
You can have small EMI, no? Like for example, once EMIs are fixed, lay, say for about 7 years, the repayment period.
No, we have
all EMIs are there. He cannot close the loan.
We have 9 years EMI schedule, but farmers are getting huge profit. They are ready to pay the whole amount within a period of 2 or 3 years. Yesterday I was with a custom hiring owner. He tells us that he is getting full amount of loan for one period, 1 year, is only from extra reaper. He has done extra reaper work about 600 trolley in just 2 months, and now ready to pay the whole EMI of this year only through one implement, that is extra reaper. So farmers are now ready to pay the whole amount of loan within a period of 2 years or 3 years. That's why we are keeping this lock-in period of 4 years. So at least this center should not close before 4 years.
Lock-in period means it has a different meaning.
No, it a banking.
They should not
lock-in.
No, that is the, you must say, minimum period required to claim subsidy. So right from the third month onwards, some EMI will be there, no? They have to pay a small EMI. But if you say 4 years, don't pay anything to bank,
lock-in
period means that is a running of...
Just clearing. At the...
Yeah, correct.
No, I am...
That is fine.
I am just telling, if a case of this project, assume that 25 lakhs case of custom hiring is sanctioned by bank. So 40% amount, subsidy amount is about 10 lakhs. So after sanctioning bank, 10 lakhs is being provided by government to bank initially, and bank kept this amount as in a reserve fund as back-ended. It means when farmer repays his amount of 15 lakhs including his margin money, then he will get the benefit of this 10 lakh at the end of as last EMI, we can say. So we provide subsidy to banks initially at the time of starting the center, but banks are adjusted these subsidy amount at the end of the KIF.
How many people got loan out of these 2000?
All 100% eligible scheme. We have no option. Without bank loan, we are not providing. So it is compulsion to beneficiary to take bank loan, and we are providing subsidy as back-ended to bank, not to beneficiary directly. One more program was started last year, that is E Kisan Sarthi, for providing additional work to these custom hiring centers. We have an IT platform known as E Kisan Sarthi, and we are running this program with the help of Aisher Tractor and EM3 services. They have created a toll free number and a call center. So farmers are now booking, are taking advantage of booking like Ola Uber through this program. In addition, when we started different programs, the state is providing subsidies in a huge way. So a number of customs and hiring centers are now also increased more than 2000. So we are facing some different type of problem. Now farmers are facing problem in repair and maintenance after sales. So state government has decided to start a skill development program in the field of farm mechanization, and we started 5 skill development centers. They are sanctioned by RKBY, and these centers are costing about 3.5 crores each with fully residential facility, and we have an MOU with leading tractor companies. We have signed MOU with Mahindra, John Deere, International, New Holland, and they are providing instructors with training material, cut models, basic tools, machines, and a 45-day program is prepared with the help of ASCII, Agriculture Skill Council, and
This 3.5 crores investment is done by the stake or?
From RKBY, ma'am. We took this program. No, this center is especially for providing training to rural youth, and we have a separate scheme for establishing rural workshop. So after getting 45 days training, now they are getting job in the dealer network of tractor companies. And in addition to this, we have started, ma'am, we have one more component in the skill development program, that is, if a rural youth wants to establish his own workshop in rural area, so state has decided to provide 50% subsidy to establish his workshop in rural area. And when I take advice from tractor manufacturers, they were saying that the rural workshop costs about 4 lakh. So we decided to provide 2 lakh as subsidy, and remaining 2 lakhs will be arranged by bank loan in Mudra Yojana. We have now negotiations with bank, and banks are now ready to provide rupees 2 lakh loan from Mudra scheme of banks. So this year we are planning to establish about 500 rural workshop in the state. So after creation of this type of facility, farmers will get a benefit of repair and maintenance facility within a radius of 10 kilometers, and it will also provide employment chances to rural youth. So this scheme is now started from this year, and we have budget provision from 18-19 to provide rupees 2 lakh to rural youth. When these workshops were established, farmer will definitely get benefit of repair maintenance. And I think if a good technology machine, if we are unable to provide after sales or basic adjustments, farmer rejects the technology completely and says that this is not a good machine for us. So it is very important to create such type of infrastructural facility to create awareness and to use these machines properly. As I told in my presentation, every state has some different type of problems. So we also identified some issues, and one is seed quality improvement program. Maximum farmers use their farm saved seed. About 60-70% farmers uses their own seed. So by a little intervention of simple grading, he can increase his productivity by 10-15%. So state government has decided to provide a spiral grader, a simple machine of about 4,000 each, and a seed treating drum of about 2,500 to all villages of Madhya Pradesh. About 52,000 villages are there. So government has provided these all machines to all villages of the state, and farmers are now getting advantage of free grading. This program really helps us, and it increases the productivity of 10 to 15%, especially for small and marginal farmers. As I told, in some part of our state, particularly Bundelkhand region of Madhya Pradesh, we have still some area of broadcasting. So state has decided to promote line sowing. Without talking about new mechanization, first we have decided to convert this area from broadcasting to line sowing by promoting use of seed cum fertilizer drill. So a big campaign was launched, and about 5 lakh hectare have been already converted into line sowing. One more intervention was deploying, because deploying work is generally avoided by farmers due to heavy wear and tear in their tires of tractor. So state has decided to promote this deploying through Haldar scheme, in which we are providing 2000 rupees per hectare as subsidy. Now we have completed above 5 lakh hectare in this program. One more very important thing is that in Madhya Pradesh we have very limited quality manufacturers in the state. Maximum implements are now being provided by Punjab manufacturers or other part of the country. So state has decided to promote agriculture manufacturers to come in the state. With so in our new industrial policy, the state government has decided this sector as a priority sector, in which a manufacturer who establishes his unit, he will get extra benefit of land cost or some other benefits, in which some special category involved. So state has decided to promote good and quality manufacturers to come in the state and start their unit, and due to this we have recently signed an MOU with one manufacturer of Kolkata. Now he is establishing his unit in Bhopal with an investment of about 100 crores, and we have already provided about 20 acres land near to Bhopal with subsidized rate. So after establishing of such big units, the farmers of the state will get quality implements at reasonable prices.